the windows down to shoot to the neighbors. So that, like, in brief, it was like for like 7 hours we couldn't go to the kitchen or like to the bathroom. I was really, I needed to go. I couldn't go. I was sitting in one place, and even though all that was going on, we have the peace of God within us, but it was so cold because the soldiers opened the main doors of the house and the cold air was like running through. I was extremely shaking from cold. So
what was your main objective here, being in your house? What did they tell you?
The soldiers didn't say anything. They just told us to stay in the room and not to leave until they tell us to. But we kept hearing soldiers coming down, and then soldiers going up. And one of the main reasons for that is to bring more people to the roof.
So how many people did you say were here? How many soldiers?
Well, we saw about 5-6, but through the noise we did hear maybe there's about, let me say, no less than 50 soldiers at least.
Overall about 200.
But around like this area about 200 soldiers. It was really a mess here.
So when they left, they didn't tell you that they left?
No.
And you said that before they've been known to leave people locked up and not tell them.
Yeah, when they put us in this room, the soldiers asked where is the key for this door, and then we told them that we don't have a key for like this door, and the soldiers have checked both doors and make sure that there like was no keys for these. And it's been known that soldiers used to go to houses and